There is somebody in Nanaimo who is setting things on fire. It happened again early this morning, and police are asking for your help tonight. They are desperate to catch the fire bug before people are killed. The latest arson happened this morning at about 4 o'clock as three homes under construction burned to the ground. The latest in a series of suspicious fires in the harbor city. Nobody has been hurt yet, but authorities fear it is just a matter of time. A-News reporter Jonathan Bartlett has our top story.
By the time fire crews get to Stonewater Drive, three structures are on fire, a carriage house and two homes, one a show home for a new development. All three houses were still under construction and unoccupied.
There's a fair bit of heat coming off there, so we couldn't get too close. We just came and tried to protect the exposures around the houses that were still intact. And then eventually we got some monitors and 2.5-inch hose lines on the structure.
The inferno is a little too close for comfort for this family, who along with their disabled son had to escape in a hurry.
I looked out and the house behind us was just roaring fire everywhere. My husband ran down to get our son and I phoned 911.
My parents, when my dad yelled, the house was on fire, it kind of freaked me out.
But their house is only a little worse for wear. Broken windows and charred eaves. Across the road, vinyl siding melted with the heat. One witness reported a suspicious person seen leaving in a pickup truck just as fire crews showed up.
The fire is still under investigation, but all indications point to an arsonist at work, especially when you take into account this is the second such fire in a matter of just 3 days.
Another day, another house under construction goes up in flames and damages four other homes. This was Monday night. The fire, shot by a viewer, is also considered an arson, as is the fire that was intentionally set in a classroom at McGurr Elementary on May 26th.
We've had three fires over the last week.
Police and fire officials are now appealing to the public for any information about these fires.
There is no link between any of these fires at this point. They appear at this point in time to be isolated, but they are still conducting the investigation.
We're looking for help from the public, anybody who has information, and we're asking them to contact us. And prior to that, if they see any suspicious activity in the area, anything they deem worthwhile, call the police.
The show home from today's fire was called The Greenhouse, a demonstration home for Build Green Technology and a fundraiser for the Canadian Home Builders Association. It was built mostly by volunteer labor.
We had a lot of people put their time and money into this house on a donation basis. And a lot of guys this year, it's been tough for everybody, and everybody stepped up to the plate and donated when they maybe shouldn't. And it's gone.
No one was injured in any of these fires, but if the arsons continue, fire crews say it's only a matter of time before someone is hurt or killed. In Nanaimo, Jonathan Bartlett, A News.